everybody. It's Darby with rejoiceandcreate.com. And I have a little project for you today for Easter. It's this adorable little bunny basket. And it was made for a Ghirardelli mini chocolate bunny. Now, the bunny themselves, they're about 3 inches long by about 1.5 inches wide. And there are other chocolates on the market which would fit in that space as well. But I thought it's an adorable little basket to make, and you can leave them around on your coworker's desk, or you can leave them on your family's dinner table as a favor. And I thought it's a great way to use up some of the papers that I had sitting around. For this one, I used the fresh florals from Stampin' Up. And that's in powder pink. And for these two, I use the wood texture paper. It doesn't take much. You can use from your scrap bin mostly, with maybe the exception of the cardstock I used for the handle. Because I used the layering ovals for the handle, and I used the largest one, you need a piece of cardstock that's 3 inches by 4 inches to be able to cut the handle. And I used the largest oval die, and not the next one, but the third one down. As you can see, when I set it on there, I set it like this, and it created an oval frame. And you get the center oval to do with another project with, but for the frame, I went ahead and folded it in half, and that's why you need a piece that's 3 inches by 4 inches for the cardstock. All right, so let's go ahead and let you know everything that you need. All right, so you just need a piece of designer series paper that's 2.5 inches. By 3 inches, and this one's from the Whole Lotta Lovely. A piece of cardstock that's 3 inches by 4 inches for your handle, for the oval for your handle. And then you just need whatever other embellishments you want for the side of the basket. I have a piece of Old Olive 1/8 inch ribbon, which I'm going to use because it kind of echoes the green and the Whole Lotta Lovely paper I chose. But for this one, I used the triple leaf punch, and I used the little bird from the tree builder punch. For this one, I used 3 punches from the blossom builder, just the little small flower that was there. Really, I'm looking around all my punches and all my dies, and there's quite a few different things I could embellish with, so look around your stash and see what you've got to make your baskets a little bit prettier. And I did not do any stamping for this one. If you want to, you can. Teeny Tiny Wishes stamp set does have a small Happy Easter. If you want to put that on there, you can stamp it on a little tag and hang it on the side of the basket. But I didn't do that. I thought these were adorable as they were. All right, so let's get started. This goes pretty quickly once we have all the pieces together. But let me go ahead and put my flat plate down there. Show you, I just lined this up. I just put my 3 inch by 4 inch piece of cardstock on. I put the largest of the oval dies, the non-scalloped ones, and the third largest, and centered that in there on my plate. And you can use some washi tape or some post-it tape to hold it down while you run it through, but just run it through like that. And I'll be right back. Okay, so this is what we have, and it gives us a beautiful oval that we can use for another project. I set those aside, and it gives us an oval frame that we can use for our handle. And all I did to get my oval frame ready was to fold it in half, because let me bring back this one. I do have 2 handles on there, and that's just the oval frame folded in half, and it holds the top of the bunny in there. If it slips at all, you can even stick it with a glue dot to hold it in, but it will hold it between the 2 arms of the handle. All right, so let's go ahead and we'll just fold this one in half and get it ready. And so it will stick. I'm just going to put a little bit of adhesive. I'm using glue. You can use glue dots. You can use just a little bit of snail or something. It just holds the handles together and creates a little bit of tension so you can slip your bunny in there. All right, so while that stays down, let me put that on there for a minute to hold it. Let's go ahead and score our basket. This is very quick. All right, with the 3-inch side up, you just want to score it at 3/4 of an inch and 2 1/4 of an inch. Now, if you're scoring on the trimmer, just 3/4 of an inch from both sides. All right, turn it the other way. And then you want to score it at 1 inch and 1.5 inches. And if you're, again, if you're scoring on the trimmer, you can just score 1 inch from both sides. And that is it. All right, so let's go ahead and fold and burnish our score lines quickly. There aren't many of them. All right, so I don't know if you'll be able to see these, but what we want to do is looking at it in portrait with the narrow side up, you'll see that there is a bigger rectangle, a small narrow one, and another bigger one. The small one we're going to free by just cutting up the score lines on both sides. And do the same thing, turn around 180 degrees, and again with the other side, other short side. Cut right up to that first score line. Okay, so that's what we have. And that's pretty much all we need. So turn that over. So put the side that you want on the outside down. Fold these two little tabs in because we want them on the inside when we make our basket. I'm going to use some tear and tape. On one side of the basket, let's put some tape on both of the end tabs. And I'm going to trim that one down a little. All right, so let's go ahead and undo it. But leave it right there for the moment. Okay, so now is where we take the handle, stick it down about 1/4 inch and center it between the sides. So go ahead and put that there. Stick the corner of that basket into the tape. And then, making sure these tabs are in, pick up your basket and we're going to line up this side with this side and stick it together. If you're not quite even on the top and the bottom, like see this one, there's a very slight difference between the two, line up the top corner of the basket and the edge. And then just squish it together. Okay? And we'll do that right on the other side. Make sure that tab is up. Line up that top corner of the basket and go ahead and squish it together. Okay, so you have a shape like this where it's open. Let's see if you can see that in there. There's open in there, and we're going to stick our fingers in and pick those tabs up and push them out to where they kind of catch on that, where that scoring is. That's where you want it to sit, right there where that scoring is. See? Okay, so that's our basket, essentially. So what I'm going to do is put my little Ghirardelli bunny in there, and I just kind of folded up the bottom. I think he fits better with the little bottom folded up there. Yeah, you can put one little glue dot to hold that up if you need to. All right, so what I did is I kind of sandwiched the top part of the wrapper right there between the two handles. All right, so what I did next was I had some shred from the dollar store. So whatever shred you have, you don't need much. And I took a few of these and just twisted the middles together. And then I just tucked it on one side of the bunny inside that tab. I don't know if you can see, but the little tab is right next to the bunny. Maybe on the side better. See, that little tab is right next to the bunny. So I tucked it between that tab and the bunny. And you just tuck that down in there. And on the other side as well. Just a couple of these things. Kind of twist it in the middle. Just gives a little look like it's a basket stuffed with a little Easter grass. And again, right on the side, inside of that tab, right next to the little Ghirardelli bunny. And I think that's really adorable. But we're going to embellish it a little bit more. So go ahead and take your piece of ribbon, and certainly you can embellish it with whatever you want. If you have some twine around you want to use, I'm just going to make a little quick bow with what I have left. It was actually sitting on my desk from another project. I should do that sometime. Maybe just do a what's on my desk and just pan back and show you what a disaster the rest of my desk is, that this is the only clear space. And then maybe do a project with what's sitting around on my desk. And I think I'm going to go ahead and decorate this basket with the flowers that were similar to my powder pink fresh florals basket. So I have some scrap powder pink left over, and let me cut a little piece of it so I can fit it into the punch. And this is the flower I'm going for. So let me move this over so I can punch out three of those. All right, so I have three of these flowers. If you have the tree builder punch, that one has a very sweet little blossom in there as well. All right, so I want to have the little dimensions, so let me put my little flowers on my piercing mat. And I'm just gonna use the back of my piercing tool to kind of indent the middle of it a little bit. And I have some pearls left over, so I'm using those up. So let me put a big pearl in the middle of each of them. And let me find my glue dots. And let's just cluster them all on this side here. And then use a glue dot to put my ribbon in place. You can tie it around the one of these I actually tied around the handle, and you can do that as well. And that's our project. Let me bring my other ones back in here. All right, so that's our project today. A very sweet and adorable little basket for a nice little treat. In this case, a Ghirardelli chocolate bunny. So I hope you like the project and give it a try. If you need more information, please go to rejoiceandcreate.com for this project and other projects I posted. If you liked the video, I would appreciate a thumbs up, and please subscribe so you can see new videos as I post them. And as always, until we meet again, I hope your days are blessed. Bye!